Hey, how's it going? My name is Shanique Alcine.
Hey, and I'm Kevon Painter. And today we have a little documentary on late bloomers, something we can really relate with.
Yeah, me and Kevon, we were best friends till like fifth grade. We went to the same middle school in Scotch Plains, Fayetteville, and at Terrell Middle School. And, you know what I mean, me and Kevon, we just do whatever you wanted to do. You know what I mean? We got in trouble. You know what I mean? Hanged out with friends, did what we're not supposed to. And that's just the point of late blooming. And, you know what I mean? Basically, what late blooming is you're just doing whatever you want and not knowing what you're supposed to do. It's not taking responsibility like you're supposed to. And basically, just blooming at the last minute to just, that's when you just realize that, you know, I have to buckle down and do what I'm supposed to do. So that's basically what late blooming is.
Yeah, we could really relate to that once again. We've used to have bad grades and used to do a whole lot of bad things and get kicked out of classes, all that kind of stuff like that. But then we come to realize that it really does take a toll. And we recently turned around. We're both going to Howard University in D.C. in the fall, something that we're very proud of. Now, today we have a couple of late bloomers, and then we also have another kid who's doing the right thing all the time throughout his whole 4 years. Now, we're going to document a couple of these people and then see how their senior year and their lives change. We have a couple of teachers and administrators who are going to also be interviewed, and we're going to see how that goes. We have Petros Petridis. He's not the late bloomer. He's the kid that came in and did what he had to do all 4 years, and he's going to Columbia University. Now, we have a couple of teachers and other administrators that are going to talk about Petros, and you're going to see how his high school went.
After Petros, we have Melvin Hansels and Brandon Boyd, close friends of mine that we played basketball together. These kids, you know, they never took high school as serious as other students, but thank God, senior year, they found out that, you know what I mean, it's time to do what they're supposed to do, and they got on crunch time, and now they're going to college as well. So basically, you're going to see two students a little bit about their lives at high school and their high school career and how they basically changed it.
Here at Scotch Plains Fanwood High School. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about the college application process for students in high school and give you some examples of different situations that impact on students and in the selection process, as well as assuring that students get into a college of choice, you know, rather than having to settle for a college that they may not have wanted to attend, but they had no other options. So I'm going to start first talking about that student that comes in as a ninth grader and begins to focus immediately at that point. The freshman year is probably the most important year in terms of the college admission process, because the freshman year is the year where those grades determine how much work a student needs to put into their high school experience in building that GPA and class rank. So therefore, if you start off in your freshman year with a very strong GPA, that means that each year that comes after that will add on to that first GPA and make it a lot easier for that student to sustain that better than average GPA, which basically is required now to get into most four-year colleges.
For myself, I'd probably have to say hardworking. Throughout my entire high school experience, I tried to get the best grades possible while still maintaining a level of high academic rigor and at the same time participating in as many extracurricular activities as possible. I really wanted to try to get involved as much as I can in my high school career while still maintaining good grades. Like some of the sports I did was track, winter track, I did spring track 1 year, but I've been playing football for 4 years now.
It's something that you must work for. You must develop a master plan around that decision that you've made. And that doesn't necessarily mean that you have to know what ultimate career you're going to pursue or college major. Just the idea that I know for sure that I want to go to college and how can I make that happen? Well, that happens by totally being aware that every year, every grade that you get and every subject that you take is going to mean something when a decision is made. It will determine what college you will ultimately get accepted at. So each year, it's just building that profile of yourself until you get to your senior year. By that time, it's kind of all over in terms of what you're able to do. So a student that I've worked with for 4 years has started off as a freshman, being very clear about the fact that they wanted to go to college, made sure with proper advisement from me that they took the appropriate courses, that they got good grades. By the time we get to the junior conference, we can basically sit down and talk about specific colleges, and that student at that point will have a pretty good idea as to whether they're going to be accepted or not.
My GPA is a 4.56. When I'm not on the football field or when I'm not in a club, the majority of my time I spent studying. I had to study. I was taking many APs and all accelerated classes, and in order to maintain those good grades, I had to spend my nights and most of my afternoon studying. My SATs, I got a 2300 on my SATs. To do that, I had to buy the blue book. I did a couple practice tests, and then I took the real thing.
I've been teaching Petros Petridis in my English Literature Advanced Placement class since September. Petros is the kind of student who is exemplified by his intellectual curiosity and by his sense of personal commitment to the development of his academic skills. Petros is the kind of student that teachers love to have in their classes. He takes every assignment very seriously. He intuitively knows the purpose behind the readings, the writings, and any other kind of assignment that a teacher might give out to students.
The ultimate goal for me was college. I really wanted to get into a good university by the end of my senior year, and I knew that the only way to do that was to get the good grades and to be as active as possible. Ultimately, I really wanted to go to a university such as Columbia, and thankfully I achieved that, and I accomplished my goal, my dream.
Perhaps the most distinguishing characteristic is that Petros takes notes every day. He doesn't wait to have anything written down on the blackboard. He doesn't wait to be told that something is important and he needs to take note of it. Instead, he realizes that all of the information given to him in class, whether it's going to be asked about later on a test or an essay, is important to the understanding of the subject.
Most people think of a nerd, they think of that guy who just spends every single waking minute in his house just studying, just constantly, and that's not what I am whatsoever. As I've already said, I'm involved so much in the school, and I do so many other things besides studying. Of course, studying, of course, is important, but if you're not a well-rounded individual, then I guess you could be classified as a nerd, but I don't see myself as that way, and I think by being involved, I prove that I am not that person.
And to me, that is the mark of a student who is actively engaged with his studies. beyond a doubt, Petros will be extraordinarily successful because he applies this same demeanor, this same technique to not only his studies, but also to the way he conducts himself in school and outside of school. Whether it's in social relationships or on the football field, he's intensely aware of the importance of how he acts and what he does and what it means to other people and to his future success.
Football is an experience I can never forget. The type of friends and the people you meet and the people you fight with on the line is just something that you cannot experience anywhere else. Just, they become your brothers, basically, the people on the line, and it's just an experience that can never be matched and something I'll never forget.
My name's John Stack. I'm a football coach here at Scotch Plains Fanwood High School and a social studies teacher. I've known Petros since his freshman year as a football player. And you know, what stands out to me the most about Petros was his sophomore year. And usually sophomores, they'll take a back seat to the seniors and let the seniors, you know, run the show at practice. And they get pushed around. But not Petros. You know, Petros came out there, and I just remember him every practice actually taking it to the seniors, which is, doesn't always happen. That this was a kid that showed up from the first day his sophomore year and was, you know, strapped that helmet on and was just going after the seniors, trying to earn his spot, earn his time. And it was the first time we really noticed a sophomore that young, you know, that early on. You usually wait till junior year when you really start to figure out how these kids are going to play for varsity, but not Petros. Once Petros was that sophomore, he came on that football field and he was not just beating some seniors, but our captains, you know. That's something that was always, that always stood out to me for Petros. He took that work ethic his sophomore year, carried it into his junior year, and then had a great senior year for us too. Always worked harder than everybody else on the field, and that's what made him the kind of guy he was.
Just keep in mind that the decisions you make in your high school will follow you for the rest of your life. You will be becoming adults now. You'll be entering the working world and the real world. And if you get involved with the wrong stuff, it will follow you. It will have terrible, terrible, terrible consequences. And just keep your eyes focused on a goal and strive to achieve excellence.
Well, my high school career, to one word describe it, I would say difficult.
Why?
Difficult because I started off like on track, playing basketball and everything, and then I like get into partying and hanging out. I just, like, one year I was ineligible playing basketball, and then I don't know, I just got a lot of trouble, suspensions, and like now I'm struggling to graduate, so that's why I would say it's difficult.
Say difficult.
Why would you say it's difficult?
I would say it's difficult because the work was hard. It was hard to stay focused with all the females running around, the parties, and I was into a lot of different things than schoolwork.
My main goals was first to play basketball, keep my grades up, and get a scholarship for sports, whether it was track or basketball or football. But I ended up just playing basketball, didn't get a scholarship, didn't play football, didn't touch track. And my grades are ass.
As a freshman, my main goal, to be honest with you, is I was basically looking for the females, the parties. I was looking at school as a little, like a way out. I don't know. Just to bug out and do stupid stuff. I wasn't worried about schoolwork, college, or nothing.
I knew Brandon and Mel when they first came to the high school. They were in my Algebra 1 team talk class. There was two teachers in the class, just like how this one is. And to put it bluntly, they were a handful, definitely. Probably, they were both in the same class, along with some of their closest buddies, and definitely gave me a hard time. They were fun. They were, the classes were kind of up and down. but they definitely came in and knew that they could, you know, get a rise out of me by doing exactly what they weren't supposed to be doing. Their math skills were definitely strong enough to pass them through, but they definitely should have done better than just passing. It was a disappointment to see how little they got out of the class, math-wise, but definitely from start to finish, I noticed like a slow positive progression from when they first started.
I think I'll end off just working at a job, you know, around where I live, like Sears or, you know, Dollar Tree or something. And I think I'll just be making money and just be satisfied with the money I was making. And then never ended up going to college. And then next thing you know, I'm like 26, 27, still around Scotch Plains, working at Sears. So yeah, I think I'll just be ending up staying where I'm at now and not going anywhere in my life.
If I never thought about college, I think I'll still be here doing the same thing. It'll just be a recap every single day. Go home, go to work, come back from work, seeing the same people, same boring stuff every single day. Now I'm going to college, and it'll be better for me.
As a student, I changed not only with my grades, but just with my, like, my maturity level. Like, now instead of going home on the week, like on the weekends, just going out partying, now I might stay in on the night, finish this essay real quick, because, you know, I got to get my grades up, I got to go to college. And also mature in the sense that I see school as like something that like it's just opportunity for me. Like a lot of people don't have like opportunity to go to Scotch Plains High School and excel. Like they might go to a school that's not as good as a school. So I see school as like a good thing now instead of just like, oh, I don't want to be here. First of all, I gotta do this English report. Mr. Mason gave me two big ass books. Like, yo, what's going on? And I gotta do stuff in Mr. Kessel. You know, I mean, nutrition project. She's crazy. Yeah.
Everybody enjoyed it. What is it, like the last one?
Yeah, everybody signed yearbooks and stuff. I'm trying to graduate. Like, it's an hassle, man.
Yo, you should have got that out the way, bro.
Should have got out the way. I waited till the last minute. Like a dummy, like I always do. And I mean, I'm knocking out right now. I'm a graduate.
Alright, what's up? It's gonna be harder, but.
Don't worry, bro. You know we. You know how it is. You already know.
And we've also definitely seen, and I know we want to definitely talk about Brandon with a grade that he earned this year, that when these two guys set a goal for themselves and they say, like, they'll get right up in our faces, like, we're going to, you know, Brandon one semester, one marking period was like, I'm getting an A this marking period. And we're like, okay, Brandon, show us. Okay, all right, you know. And he got an A.
He did.
He was so determined. It was almost to be like, I'm going to prove it to you that, you know, that I know this.
I can turn it on and turn it off.
As a student, I think I changed by being more focused on my schoolwork, going into my guidance counselor, trying to get into colleges, and not worried about what everybody's doing after school. I'm staying after school, trying to get my work done so I can get into college. And in classes, not fooling around or going to sleep or cracking jokes or trying to talk to somebody. I was just taking notes. Like, I never used to do that stuff, take notes or nothing. I would either leave the classroom, go to the bathroom, walk around, or just be in class acting stupid. But now I just manned up, grew up and started taking notes and doing my work, doing what I'm supposed to do.
Yeah, and we definitely notice a change in not even just the math, because a lot of what we do in the classroom is not just about math. It's really about, you know, like educating our kids to be just like good people and to be able to leave the high school and to do something with themselves. And I mean, even this year, like I know that we worked with Brandon on like proofreading essays for him and, you know, reminding them of the college process and just like different things like that to make sure they had all their ducks in a row. But I definitely noticed with the two of them, especially from freshman year, from when I had them, that they matured so much in terms of the respect that they showed their teachers, and they realized that, like, wow, you know, they're not trying to like bat us down. They're not trying to put us down. They really want us to do well and to.
We're on their side. We're here to help them. We're not here to let, you know, tell them what to do and when to do it. You know, we're here almost to, you know, as support system to help them out, you know, and prepare them for life after high school.
Yeah.
You know, when they're on their own.
Yeah. So I've definitely noticed with both of them that by no means do we have any behavior problems with them. I mean, we like to have fun, we joke around, they definitely have strong personalities and stand out and crack us up all the time. But I mean, compared to freshman year when, I mean, I used to leave school crying with headaches because of like the amount of effort that I had to put in just to get them to sit and just like at least close their mouth so I could teach somebody else. You know,
and now they have that respect. They know that, you know, when they're being disruptive in class, they're not just disrupting, you know, they're not just annoying us. They may be affecting the whole class or, you know, how everybody's learning. It's not just affecting their learning. And I think that they've matured in that sense that, you know, they are aware of the people around them and they don't want to negatively affect them, you know, if they're not taking the responsibility. Mm-hmm.
The big distraction for me in high school was my friends and my ex-girlfriend. That was a big distraction for me, you know what I'm saying? I wasn't focused at all. You know, my mind was just on what I'm gonna do with my friends, when am I gonna chill with my girlfriend? And I wasn't like thinking about school, I was just thinking about the other things, the less important things. And I think that messed me up a lot because it made my mind focus on the things that the mind shouldn't be focusing on at the age I was. I should be focusing on school and getting to college, but instead I was focusing on partying and chilling with my girl. So, you know, I think that was my biggest distraction, my friends and my girlfriend.
Biggest distraction in high school was definitely my friends, because I was always friends with the older crowd, and I was trying to do what they was doing, getting in trouble, doing stupid stuff, just to fit in with the crowd. And then finally chose my own route, started getting my work done, and forgot all about that stuff.
Most people help me get in the right role, but it was mostly my friends, you know? Watching my friends excel, have their mind straight, got into good colleges, I'm thinking they're just like me, I can do the same thing. So I decided to turn my life around, you know, get my work done, go to my guidance counselors, bug my guidance counselors about I need this, I need that, you know, talk to colleges, write colleges, you know, try to talk to coaches about basketball, ask my coach for a highlight tape, you know, just little things like that. And I think that just the people around me, my friends, started to grow up. So I think, you know, it's time for me to grow up too. And I think that's what basically helped me have my mind focused.
I'll have to say some of my friends and Miss Page, I like to think, that helped me get on the right road. And the same thing he says, seeing all my other friends get into colleges, doing their thing, about to go way different places. My friend Shanique Cavani going all the way to Howard University in D.C. Everybody going different routes all around the world, and I'll just be staying here and doing the same stuff over and over. So I'll definitely say my friends and teachers helped me get in the right road.
All right, I'll start off with the worst. The worst moments of being a class clown is eventually, you know what I mean, you get everybody laughing and now you kicked out now. Now you suspended. Damn. Now that sucks. But the best part is when you can get everybody to laugh and the teacher to laugh as well. Because the teacher's supposed to be, you know, the disciplinarian. Like, nah, stop that. But if you get her to laugh as well, it's like you even got the teacher to laugh, so you must be doing something right. So I think that's the best part.
So the same thing. The best part is when you crack the little joke and everybody laughing, everybody having a good time, the teacher too. But the bad part is when the teacher ain't think it was funny and she yelling at you and kicking you out of the classroom. And now you sitting in the office like, damn, I didn't have to tell that joke.
Right, and now, I mean, I've only known them their senior year, and you can see also, like, from the beginning of the year, they tested the waters, they wanted to see, you know, what they could get away with, and, you know, what they were, you know, able to do, and then once we tried to, like, put a stop to it and tried to get them, you know, to start doing their math work and, you know, get serious about school, you know, we almost got it out of them. You know, they realized it was senior year, they needed to start to buckle down, and, you know, if they wanted to get to school, and we kind of just kept reminding them of that. You know, like, do you want to go to college? I know you do, but, you know, you're going to need to do this, okay? Whether it's about the math or not, it's about the responsibility, and they needed to learn, you know, what I needed to do well, you know, and I can do it. And we saw it in them that they were smart kids, okay? Like, you know, they knew their math.
The advice I'll give to the freshmen is, when you come here, it's going to be a lot different from middle school. You're going to see a lot more girls. You're going to be hearing about parties and all that other stuff. It's not that important at all. That schoolwork and the books is what's really important. And if you start off late and do what I did, you might not be able to bloom. I got lucky. Everybody doesn't get lucky. I was a lucky person to get my head on right and go to college at the last minute. A lot of people still can't do that. Some of my friends trying to do the same thing as me. I'm talking to them, telling them to do what I'm doing, but it was too late for them. Like, they couldn't do it. Like, it's not everybody gets lucky. So I would just suggest y'all come here, do y'all work. Don't worry about them girls, the parties, all that other stuff. Just get your work done. Worry about that after high school.
The biggest thing I tell the freshmen is basically just be smart. You know, I'm not gonna sit here and tell the freshmen, you know, don't have a girlfriend, don't party, you know what I mean? Nobody wants to be born. Everybody's gonna have, there's a time for everything, you know? But when you come to school, it's time for school. So that means you do your work, you stay focused, you do athletics, you know, you join your clubs, you get your schoolwork done. You know what I'm saying? After school, you go home, do your homework. And then when you got the time, after that's taken care of the way, all right, it's time for a girl, chill with a girl, it's time to party a little bit, but just be smart about it. And just be yourself, you know?
I'm Coach Daugherty. I coach at Scotch Plains High School. Been a head coach here now for 7 years. Retired last season after we won the state championship. Before that, been coaching basketball about 20 years, teaching here mathematics now 9 years. Brandon and Melvin, I coached them. They were in my program for 3 years. Talented kids. Freshman year, we noticed them right away. They were talented kids. Okay, helped us win the state title. Okay, at times we had a little trouble, like a little off the court, a little on the court. So maybe they didn't meet their full potential. I mean, could have been very good players, okay, but had a little trouble on the court, a little off the court in school. But I'm really starting to come around just watching them senior year, like watching them mature and realizing they have a future looking at other things. I'd say basketball wise, I mean, if they want to, college wise, they certainly have the talent to play at the next level. Division III, junior college, okay, as Melvin, extremely athletic, okay, fabulous defender. See, probably his defense helped us win a state title. His lockdown defense on usually the best opposing player was really a plus for us. Brandon, nice shot at some great games this year that helped lead the team to some big upset wins, I know, against Shabazz. And I mean, I said, I'm not sure if they're planning on playing ball in college, but I mean, they certainly have the ability and the talent if they want to get it all together.
We definitely know that he has it in him. And when he, and I think the same thing with Mel too, I know, especially during basketball season.
Right, they both knew that their responsibility, you know, on the court, of course, you know, to like do well in the game and, you know, all that, but they needed to be doing well in school. And, you know, you could definitely see it during that season that they took school a little bit more seriously, you know, and tried their best, you know, so that they can be the well-rounded student that they want to be.
Right.
You know, that they tried to be.
So. Right.
All right. The college process was scary because it was like a last minute thing. You know, I was getting my head on the right track. I was trying to do the right thing, but at the same time, it was, you know, coming to the end. So I was thinking, like, am I gonna get to college or not? Am I gonna be going to the county? Am I gonna still be around here? But I did get accepted to a small college in New York, upstate. And I'm like proud of that because I didn't think I could do it. But yeah, the college process was, you know, it was scary though.
What's college?
The college I'm going to is Briarcliff in New York.
The whole college process was real scary to me too, because the last few months of school, I just really woke up on the wrong, different side of the bed and just decided that I'm gonna do the college thing. So it was real crunch time. I had to get my work done, handing all this stuff. I had to apply to all these colleges and all this other stuff. So when the time finally came, I still didn't think I was gonna get accepted. I was getting letters, but I wasn't getting no acceptance letter. And then one day, all of a sudden I went home and it was this mail. I was about to throw it out because I thought it was one of them same letters that I always get that's just saying some random stuff. But then I was just like, let me just open it and see what it say. And it was an acceptance letter. And put a big smile on my face, and it's a good thing. I'm going to Lincoln University in Pennsylvania.
The competitive environment that we now have in terms of college admissions, you really, that first year, that ninth grade year, is your building block. And if you start off with that strong freshman year, you only can do better each year, and that's the best scenario. So I hope this helps all of you, you know, to understand the differences and to wish you best of luck in your future endeavors.
As you've seen in this documentary, you witnessed two types of students. One student that did what he's supposed to do, came into freshman year, knew what was important and what wasn't important. Now, what he did now is benefiting him because now he just gets to pick any Ivy League school, and the college process is just a breeze. As far as the other type of student, you have students that basically came into school not caring. They didn't take school seriously. They didn't do the work. They came late to class. You know what I mean? They made everybody laugh. That was their basic duties. And how it's so hard for them to actually get into college, and they had to really crunch down in senior year. If they never crunched down, they would have never made it to college.
Now, senior year should be a breeze. It should be easy. You should come in here, get your college process done, and then from there, move on with all the senior activities at the end of the year. But without a good freshman year, a good sophomore and junior year, that is not the case. You have to come in here, put overtime work, and it makes it a lot harder than it is. Now, it's much easier to make a habit than break a habit. So what you have to do is come in here, do what you have to do, and make that your habit. Then from there, college will be good.
Thank you for watching.
It's getting close to sundown over the Sierra, stranded on a heat wave, burning with desire. She was on the sidewalk looking for a night.